Hi folks, Will from MinIO here, and in this video, I'm going to be discussing the MinIO Security Token Service in the context for our developers out there. What we're going to be talking about today is the MinIO Security Foundations, for those of you who haven't seen our Security IAM videos. I'm also going to talk a little bit about what a Security Token Service is for, and then I'm going to get into the Python STS API, when we're going to see some examples in the next video. So let's take a look at some MinIO security foundations. For those of you who have seen our Security IAM video series, this is gonna be a bit of a review, but it's always good to keep it fresh in mind. So what you get with MinIO is policy-based access control. And what that means is you're going to have authenticated users that have authorized actions. MinIO is always gonna control the policies, no matter who is doing the authentication, the authorization is always done by MinIO. It's always going to default to a deny. So if I have two rules that are in conflict with one another, let's say I've got a user rule and a group rule, if they are in conflict, then deny is going to override allow in the case of that conflict. If a user doesn't have any policy, they can't perform any operations. They can't really log in. They can't look at anything. The nice thing about MinIO policies is that they are compatible with AWS IAM policies. So if you have a bunch of those in place already, you can just import them straight into MinIO. Very easy to do. MinIO provides a few different built-in policies. The console admin has full access. This makes it kind of similar to a root user. The read-only can get specific objects, but you can't do any listing or anything like that. You have to know where the object is. Read-write can read and write all objects, all buckets. You can even do lists and things like that. Write-only can put, but cannot get, and the bucket has to already exist. I can't create buckets with the write-only. And then there's a diagnostics built-in policy. It's generally used for subnet, which is our support portal. All of the policies can be viewed with the MC admin policy list command. So as far as authentication methods go, you have a few different choices here. Again, all of the authorization is always going to be done by MinIO, but you have some options for authentication. Your first option is the simplest. It's the MinIO IDP. It's built in. You don't need any extra setup. It's going to handle users and groups just like most systems do. And the benefit there is that MinIO is going to handle both the authentication and the authorization. Of course, the downside is that you have to have a whole nother system where you're setting up a whole nother set of users and groups. If you already have a system in place, such as LDAP or OpenID, you can use those as well. In the case of LDAP, and that also includes Active Directory, MinIO is going to map users and groups in LDAP or Active Directory to policies for the authorization. So MinIO is still handling that mapping for you. In the case of OpenID, you're going to be using a JSON web token, a JWT, and in that token, there needs to be a policy claim. The claim name needs to match a valid MinIO policy name or else the login won't work. The benefit of OpenID there, things like Okta and KeyCloak, is that if you have that policy name and if that policy name exists in MinIO, there's no additional work to be done on the MinIO side. With LDAP, you need to actually do the mappings of the users and groups in LDAP to the policies in MinIO. So those are the authentication methods that are supported by MinIO today. Again, as you can see, with LDAP, OpenID, you can have some SSO, right? You can have that single sign-on capability. Now, a reminder, MinIO still controls all the policy no matter which way you are doing your authentication. This means if I'm using OpenID, I have to have that JWT with the claim name in it. If I'm using LDAP, I have to do the mapping. And of course, if I'm using the MinIO IDP, it's all just mapped out there for me as I'm using the MinIO IDP with the users and groups. Now, this is going to simplify the management of the authorized actions. So MinIO is just going to be in control of the policies all the time. What this means to you is that your data, which is what you're trying to protect with these policies, and your policies, which is what you're writing, are going to be managed by the same system. So that simplifies that management at that level. So it makes a lot of sense. So let's talk a little bit about the security token service. So first off, what is a security token service? Well, a security token service is a web service that manages security tokens. Makes sense. What it's going to do with that, it's going to issue them and renew them as needed, and also it's going to validate them and cancel them as needed. So it's going to manage the whole life cycle of the security token. What STS does, it enables that federated access using single sign-on. So STS is very common when you're using SSO. What you're going to do is you're going to request a token from your security token service, and you're going to use that to authenticate to your various services in your SSO. Now, how does MinIO implement this STS? Well, when MinIO is configured to use third-party SSO authentication, MinIO itself is going to act as the security token service. So mainly this is going to be used for accessing the MinIO itself, but you can grab a token, you can use it with other federated platforms. So it's not like you're stuck just using MinIO with STS and it just seems like a login. The application accessing MinIO with STS must request the token from MinIO or another service and then provide that to MinIO in order to implement that single sign-on. MinIO itself provides RESTful access to STS, which means that you can do a simple HTTPS call, and then managing the state of that token is largely left to the application. Obviously, the STS system is going to be able to revoke access to that token without you having to do anything extra in the application, but the application needs to manage that token so that it can go out and make multiple calls across the SSO federated services. So why are we going to use STS? Well, if MinIO is configured to use OpenID or LDAP, those users have to use STS to log in through the application. Now, if you're going in through the console, you're using LDAP, you can just log in as usual. If you're using OpenID, it'll present you with an OpenID login. But obviously, you're not going to get that if we're using an application that's written in Python or something along those lines. So you need to call the STS service to get the authentication to then perform the actions in MinIO. STS gives you this very simple interface to authenticate your application to MinIO with whatever credentials you need. And again, MinIO still retains policy controls. There's one little caveat to that. You can send in a reduced set of policy actions that you want to include, but that set has to be a subset of whatever policy is assigned to the user that you're using. We'll talk a little bit more about that in a minute. So let's talk about the MinIO Python STS API. As I've noted, the STS API is actually fairly easy to use. It's a RESTful endpoint, so you can actually just call HTTPS, okay? MinIO provides these security tokens through that endpoint. This example call that you see on your screen right now is just a simple post to HTTPS. We're calling MinIO itself, and we're using the assume role with LDAP identity. We need to hand in the username, the password, and the version at a minimum. There are some other parameters. This is the case where you might add a policy statement to access a subset of the policy. If you don't need to use all of the tools that are available to the user in this case, then you can just use a subset of those. There's full documentation there. The documentation link that you see here on the screen is also in the description on this video. Obviously, calling that RESTful endpoint through Python could get a little tedious if you're setting up an HTTP client and all that other stuff. So MinIO provides a very simple wrapper around both the LDAP identity provider and the web identity provider, which is used for OpenID. There are other providers available. There is AWS authentication. You can use that if you've federated with that. And what this does, it allows you to still have simple access to MinIO without having to go through a bunch of raw REST calls and managing a lot of tokens. So here's a little bit of LDAP example code. You can see here we're using the LDAP identity provider class. We're handing it the STS endpoint, which again is going to be MinIO, and then the LDAP username and password. Once we have used that, when we create the client, we're going to use the MinIO host, the MinIO port, and then instead of giving it a secret key and an access key, we're going to give it just this credentials. There's a really good example piece of code there. It's on GitHub. Again, this piece of code is linked in the description below. And here's a little example code for OpenID. Again, this is using the web identity provider. What we're going to do is we're going to get that JSON web token using the client ID, the client secret. We're going to use the IDP client ID, the IDP endpoint. So we're going to talk directly to KeyCloak or Okta or whoever. And then we're going to use the STS endpoint, which again is going to be MinIO, and then if there's any roles or sessions that we need to add, we're going to add those in there. And then again, when we create our MinIO client, we're going to call MinIO with the credentials with this provider instead. So the key here is that our MinIO client call that we used to use with a username password, we're now going to hand the credentials in from a third party, in this case either LDAP or OpenID. And again, we have linked to some example code there, and again, you can find that link here in the description. And that's going to conclude our video on an overview of using STS with Python and MinIO. I hope you've enjoyed the video. If you'd like to reach out with us, you can connect with us with any of the methods you see here on the screen. You can also Slack us on slack.min.io or just leave a comment here on the video. In our next video, I'm going to show you a little demonstration of using this code to actually log into MinIO using LDAP. Thanks, and we'll see you for the next one.